Hello everyone, this is Dr. Adel Bondok, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. I will talk about the joints. So what should you know about any joint? First, you should know the type of the joint. Is it synovial, fibrous, or cartilaginous? And if it is synovial, is it ball and socket, hinge, pivot, or whatever? Then you should know the articular surfaces, the bones which form the joint, and then accessory ligaments which support the capsule of the joint, and the structures inside the joint, the main structures, and then movements of the joints and the stability of the joint, mainly the hip joint. So we'll start by the type of all the joints of the lower limb. Okay, this is the hip joint, knee joint, superior tibiofibular joint, inferior tibiofibular joint, ankle joint, and the subtalar and the talocalcaneonavicular joint. This is the talocalcaneonavicular joint. Talus, calcaneus, and the navicular. Hip joint is okay. All the joints of the lower limb are synovial, except the inferior tibiofibular joint, which is fibrous. So, hip joint is synovial, ball and socket. Knee joint is synovial, condylar variety. Superior tibiofibular is synovial, plane. Inferior tibiofibular joint is fibrous. Ankle joint is synovial, hinge. And okay, synovial hinge. And the talocalcaneonavicular joint is ball and socket. Okay, then we'll talk about the articular surfaces. This is the hip joint. This is the knee joint. And this is the ankle joint. Hip joint, articular surfaces, acetabulum of the hip bone and the head of the femur. So acetabulum of the hip bone and the head of the femur. Then the knee joint. Two femoral condyles, two tibial condyles, and the patella. Ankle joint. Lower end of the tibia, lower end of the fibula, and the talus. This is the talus. There is a joint above the talus and a joint below the talus. The joint above the talus is the ankle joint. The joint below the talus is the subtalar joint between the talus and the calcaneus. Talocalcanean joint, okay? And we have another joint, talocalcaneonavicular joint, this one. The subtalar joint between talus and the calcaneus. Talocalcaneonavicular joint between the talus, calcaneus, and the navicular bone. And also this ligament, which is very important ligament, is called the spring ligament. Talus, calcaneus, navicular, and spring ligament. Then we'll start by the hip joint. Again, what should you know about the hip joint? The type, the articular surfaces. Then we'll talk about the stability, structures inside, accessory ligaments, and the movements. So the hip joint is synovial, ball and socket. Articular surfaces, acetabulum, and head of the femur. Stability. The hip joint is the most stable joint, unlike the shoulder joint. Why the hip joint is a very stable joint? First, because of the shape of the articular surfaces, okay, deep acetabulum and the smaller head, okay, so the head fits in the acetabulum, presence of acetabular labrum to increase the concavity of the acetabulum, okay, strong ligaments surrounding the joint, strong muscles surrounding the joint, plus atmospheric pressure. Structures inside the hip joint. Two structures. This cartilaginous ring is called acetabular labrum, and this ligament is called the ligament of the head of the femur or ligamentum teres of the head of the femur. What is the function of each one? Acetabular labrum deepens the concavity of the acetabulum to prevent hip dislocation. Acetabular ligament of the head of the femur, it carries arteries from the obturator artery to supply the head of the femur. So it contains acetabular artery from the obturator artery. So it carries arterial supply to the head of the femur. Just reminding you of the arterial supply of the head of the femur. The head of the femur is supplied mainly by the medial circumflex femoral artery plus the acetabular branch of the obturator artery. And the fractured neck femur will cut the blood supply to the head of the femur, causing a vascular necrosis of the head of the femur. We have three main accessory ligaments from the three parts of the hip bone to the femur. This one between the ilium and the femur, this one between the pubis and the femur, and this one between the ischium and the femur. So iliofemoral ligament, this is the first one. Second one, pubofemoral ligament. And third one, ischiofemoral ligament. What is the function of each one? Iliofemoral ligament prevents hyperextension of the hip joint. Pubofemoral ligament prevents hyperabduction of the hip joint. Ischiofemoral or ischiofemoral ligament prevents excessive medial rotation. So you should know the three accessory ligaments and the function of each one. Iliofemoral ligament prevents hyperextension. Pubofemoral ligament prevents hyperabduction. Ischiofemoral ligament prevents excessive medial rotation. Then the movements of the hip joint. The hip joint is ball and socket, so it is multi-axial. So we have flexion and extension, adduction and abduction, medial rotation and lateral rotation. I will talk about the main muscles. So the main flexor, iliopsoas, psoas major and iliacus. The main extensor is the gluteus maximus. Then adduction, adductors. The main adductors are three: adductor longus, adductor brevis, adductor magnus. The main abductors are three: gluteus medius, gluteus minimus, and the tensor fasciae latae. Remember that the abductors also medially rotate the femur. So medial rotation, gluteus medius, gluteus minimus, and the tensor fasciae latae. Regarding lateral rotation, just reminding you of the small muscles in the gluteal region: piriformis, obturator internus, the two gemelli, quadratus femoris, plus the adductors. So lateral rotation, piriformis, quadratus femoris, obturator internus, and the two gemelli, adductors. So what are the movements of the hip joint? Flexion, mainly by the psoas major and iliacus. Extension, mainly by gluteus maximus, assisted by hamstring muscles. Adduction by the three adductors, longus, brevis, magnus. Abduction, gluteus medius, gluteus minimus, tensor fasciae latae. Medial rotation, the same gluteal muscles, medius, minimus, and the tensor fasciae latae. And the lateral rotation, small muscles in the gluteal region, piriformis, quadratus femoris, obturator internus, the two gemelli, plus the adductor muscles. Okay, let us have some facts. What is the main extensor of the hip joint? It is the gluteus maximus. What is the main flexor of the hip joint? It is the psoas, iliopsoas. What is the structure which prevents hyperextension of the hip joint? It is the iliofemoral ligament. What are the adductors? Longus, brevis, magnus. What are the abductors? Gluteus medius, gluteus minimus, tensor fasciae latae. Name the structure which prevents hyperabduction of the hip joint. It is the pubofemoral ligament. Now let us go to the knee joint. Again, what should you know about the knee joint? Articular surfaces. Type. So what is the type of the knee joint? It is synovial. condyler variety. How can you remember condyler? Because the articular surfaces, condyles of the femur and the condyles of the tibia. So it is condyler. It is biaxial joint. So articular surfaces, three bones share in the formation of the knee joint. Okay, femoral condyles, tibial condyles, and the patella. The patella is very important in preventing hyperextension of the knee joint. Then accessory ligaments of the knee joint. We have two accessory ligaments, one on the medial side of the knee and one on the lateral side of the knee. This one is the tibial collateral ligament or medial ligament of the knee joint. This one is the lateral, is the fibular collateral ligament or lateral ligament of the knee joint. The tibial collateral ligament extends from the medial epicondyle to the medial surface of the tibia. And the fibular collateral ligament extends from the lateral epicondyle to the styloid process of the fibula. What is the function of the collateral ligaments, of the tibial collateral ligament and the fibular collateral ligament? They prevent side-to-side displacement of the tibia. Now, the main structures inside the knee joint. This one and this one. So, cruciate ligaments, the two cruciate ligaments, anterior and posterior, and the two menisci, medial meniscus and the lateral meniscus. Cruciate ligaments. This is the anterior cruciate ligament. It prevents hyperextension of the knee joint and it prevents anterior displacement of the tibia or posterior displacement of the femur. The posterior cruciate ligament has the opposite action. It prevents hyperflexion of the knee joint and it prevents backward displacement of the tibia. Regarding the two menisci, medial meniscus and the lateral meniscus, the medial meniscus, okay, they adapt the femoral condyles to the tibial condyles. And the medial meniscus is more liable to injury because it is fixed. It is attached to the capsule and attached to the tibial collateral ligament. So this is anterior cruciate ligament, posterior cruciate ligament, medial meniscus, lateral meniscus. You see, the medial meniscus is attached to the capsule and to the tibial collateral ligament. The lateral meniscus is separated from the fibular collateral ligament by the tendon of popliteus muscle. Therefore, rupture of the anterior cruciate ligament will cause hyperextension of the knee joint. And the medial meniscus is more liable to injury because it is more fixed. So what are the movements which occur in the knee joint? This is extension and this one flexion. Flexion, extension. What are the main flexor? Main flexors, hamstring muscles, assisted by other muscles. Extensors, this one, main extensors, extension, quadriceps, femoris, rectus femoris, vastus medialis, vastus lateralis, vastus intermedius. Then medial rotation and the lateral rotation. Medial rotation, remember SGS, sartorius, gracilis, semitendinosus, plus popliteus. Popliteus is very important because it unlocks the knee joint, and unlocking of the knee joint is medial rotation of the knee joint by the popliteus muscle. Lateral rotation, it is only one muscle, which is the biceps femoris. So lateral rotation by the biceps, medial rotation by the popliteus, and sartorius gracilis semitendinosus. Let us have some facts on the knee joint. These are the cruciate ligaments, right? Okay. What are the main structures inside the knee joint? main structures. Okay, two cruciate ligaments, anterior and posterior, anterior and posterior, and two menisci, medial meniscus and the lateral meniscus. What is the function of the anterior cruciate ligament? It prevents hyperextension of the knee joint, and it prevents forward displacement of the tibia. Therefore, rupture of the anterior cruciate ligament will cause hyperextension of the knee joint. What is the function of the posterior cruciate ligament opposite to the anterior? So it prevents hyperflexion of the knee joint and prevents posterior displacement of the tibia. Another facts. What are the functions of the menisci? Absorb shocks, adapt femoral condyles to the tibial condyles, and the lubrication of the articular surfaces. Which one is more liable to injury? It is the medial meniscus. Why? Because it is more fixed. It is attached to the capsule, attached to the tibial collateral ligament, unlike the lateral meniscus, which is separated from the capsule by the tendon of popliteus. Then the ankle joint. This is the ankle joint above the talus. Again, what should you know about the ankle joint? Okay, type and articular surfaces. It is synovial hinge. Articular surfaces from above, tibia and the fibula. From below, it is the talus. So lower end of the tibia, lower end of the fibula, and the talus. Then subtalar joint. Subtalar joint between talus and the calcaneus. Talocalcanean, it is plain. Then talocalcaneo-navicular joint. It is ball and the socket between the talus, calcaneus, and the navicular. Let us talk about the movement of the foot. Movement of the foot. Dorsiflexion and plantar flexion. Dorsiflexion is movement of the foot upward. Plantar flexion is movement of the foot downward. The other one is eversion and inversion. Eversion and inversion. At what joint each movement occurs? Dorsiflexion and plantar flexion occur at the ankle joint. Eversion and inversion occur at talocalcaneo-navicular joint and subtalar joint. What are the dorsiflexors and the plantar flexors? The anterior compartment of the leg, dorsiflexors, mainly tibialis anterior and extensor digitorum longus. Plantar flexors are the posterior compartment and the lateral compartment of the leg, but mainly gastrocnemius and soleus. Then eversion and the inversion. What is inversion? And what is eversion? Identify, define inversion. Inversion is medial rotation of the foot. Eversion is lateral rotation of the foot. What are the muscles producing each movement? Eversion, three P's: pronaeus longus, pronaeus brevis, pronaeus tertius. Can you tell me the nerve supply of each one? Pronaeus longus. Superficial peroneal nerve. Pronaeus brevis, also superficial peroneal nerve. Pronaeus tertius, deep peroneal nerve. How about inversion? The two main muscles, tibialis anterior and tibialis posterior. Okay, tell me the nerve supply of each one. Tibialis anterior, it is the deep peroneal nerve. Tibialis posterior, it is the tibial nerve. And finally, let us talk about the arches of the foot. The foot is arched, not flat. So, how many arches? We have two arches, longitudinal and transverse. So longitudinal and transverse. Regarding the longitudinal, how many? Two. One medial, this is the medial longitudinal arch, and one lateral, this is the lateral longitudinal arch. What are the bones forming each one? The medial longitudinal arch is formed by the keystone is the talus, the posterior pillar is the calcaneus, anterior pillar, navicular, cuneiform bones, and the first three metatarsal bones. How about the lateral longitudinal arch, calcaneus, cuboid, and the fourth and the fifth metatarsal bones. Transverse arch, okay, this one, navicular, cuneiform, and the cuboid. Which longitudinal arch is higher than the other? It is the medial longitudinal arch. The medial is higher than the lateral. What are the factors which support the arches of the foot? Let us start from the bones. So, the shape of the bones. Ligaments between the bones. Short muscles in the sole of the foot. Long tendons coming from the posterior compartment. And the last one is this one. We call it the tie beam. Tie beam of the arches. It is the plantar aponeurosis. So shape of the bones, ligaments between the bones, short muscles, long tendons, and the plantar aponeurosis. What is flat foot? Flat foot is loss of the arches of the foot. What are the causes? Long standing, okay, weakness of the muscles, and so on. And thank you very much. Best wishes and good luck.